The word volatility is the way people are looking at what they own, what's in their portfolios. And you see a lot of people just giving up on stocks right now. And I think that's an interesting phenomenon to have happen so close to a new all-time high. And so when you look at a breakdown of the market, SPLV versus SPHB, I think is very informative. SPLV is the low volatility segment of the S&P 500, approximately half the market. Since Fed Day, that is only down minus 0.4%, so down less than a percent. And if that's what your portfolio is overweighted toward, you don't notice any volatility at all, and that's by design. Take a look at SPHB. That's the other half of the stock market. That's the Wild West, the most volatile names. Right now, that's down 8.5% since Fed Day. That is grueling. That is an absolute huge dispersion between those two styles of investing. And then when you look at individual sectors, let's do a tale of two cities really quickly. Take a look at REITs, still working very nicely. On Friday, they made a new all-time high. Okay, very rare amongst the market. Now take a look at the other side, retail. These stocks are being liquidated. Macy's, Nordstrom, these stocks are, every bid is an opportunity to sell. Bed Bath & Beyond,
we'll get into some of those retail names, and for good reason, like Josh is bringing up. But Steph, you know, maybe reality setting in a little bit across the street that it's going to be a slog here forward. You know, summer's almost over. You get into a seasonally tough period. I mentioned the notes. Let's show you the wall that we made to sort of encompass what you're getting today from Wall Street. Morgan Stanley, right? Mike Wilson. You see what the bear is alive and kicking. He's going to be with us later this week to expand more on his thoughts about where he thinks we're going to go from here. Bank of America, recession risks are rising. UBS, 10-year to 1.25. That can't be good for stocks, can it? Goldman Sachs, a bigger growth hit from the trade war. This is why I use the word reality. In fact, reality setting in that, you know, you have a lot of stuff going on, and a lot of it's not seemingly good.
No, definitely not. I mean, the longer the trade war goes on, obviously, the worse it's going to be. I don't think we're going to see negative interest rates unless we're going into a recession. I still don't think you're going to go into a recession. I think the consumer probably kind of props us up to, you know, low single-digit growth on GDP, and that's what's been the case, and that's been what's been happening over the last couple of quarters. So I think the big question is, what does it do to business confidence, consumer confidence? That's what I'm worried about, and that's what I'm watching. But if you look at the equity risk premium spread at 450 basis points, stocks are very attractive relative to bonds and relative to where interest rates are. And so you want to own quality. I've said it all year long, you want to own a barbell because we don't know you're going to get fits and starts on trade. But at the same time, you can't lose your shirt, so you have to have some defensives as well. Dividends are much more attractive, though, at this point, and that's where I'm at.
Jimmy, size it up for me.
If you want a quick fix to this, the only way to get that is to get something positive coming on talks with China, which there's no indication of. So, you know, and that's being shown in the cyclical sectors, right? You look at industrials, you look at basic materials, energies, just getting slaughtered, okay? Those stocks are saying recession is here now. And you know what? It's longer. You point out corporate confidence. It's not going to happen right now, but eventually, as this continues on, corporate confidence decreases, wage growth slows, and the labor market falters. That takes a few months. What cannot come to the rescue is central banks, not central banks on their own. And yes, they're going to cut in response to this, but if you don't get resolution on China, you not only need central banks, but you need governments to start spending. And with low interest rates, look, I don't want to sound like a modern monetary theorist here, but with low interest rates, you can get away with it. So the government better be primed to start spending on infrastructure unless they solve China.
Is what Steph says enough? Stocks are attractive relative to bonds.
I got to politely say no, because here's the problem. We've been, all of us, looking for a second half recovery in earnings. Now we're looking for a 2020 recovery in earnings. After a certain point in time, you have to get China resolved if you're going to get a recovery in earnings at any point.
So you might be talking about the wrong China resolution. The trade deal is, I think the lack of a trade deal is starting to really filter through and impact not only corporations, small businesses, but just regular people.
Yeah, that,
in a way that
is reality setting.
Hold on,
right? That's why I asked.
But is that the worst thing? Because the other shoe that may drop is an armed incursion into Hong Kong, which I don't think anyone is thinking about in terms of like their earnings estimates.
They are starting to today. The airport shut down.
Like,
they are today.
Like this is now an issue that's spilled over from politics onto the business pages. Like, people are looking at this and saying, what does this mean? Does this mean the yen goes limit up? If something happens, like, Josh, and I am not an expert on this kind of thing, but I'm just saying this is something that investors are now paying attention to.
I think it forces China to come to the table.
I'm just going to say that, I mean, obviously we have to watch this. And as I said earlier on, that the longer this drags out, the worse it's going to be. But the NFIB small business optimism, the confidence numbers are still quite strong. 103.3 last reading, right? JOLTS, really strong. I mean, these are still very solid pockets of the economy.
You would agree that that's based on the stock market, and that can turn on a dime, right?
It can turn, for sure. But, I mean, your average on the NFIB index is 98. You're at 103.3 in the face of all of this that's going on.
I'm just saying,
so small businesses are
that's
still
a wealth
okay
effect coincident
point
indicator,
I don't know,
and it moves with the stock market.
We shall see.
And it can very quickly tell a different story.